I was one of the biggest driver because I stay very near the place, only 5 minutes from my house. But I thank to Jason, because recently I was not coming from my home, so he used me as a second driver. But I think it was an honor to be able to drop him back, because he always share a lot of things with me. Not just about public speaking, sometimes about how he felt about things. And I remember there was one time before the 2014 Toastmasters International Convention. He was so excited because it will be happening in Penang, KL for the first time. And he wanted to be one of the speakers in the convention. And to be eligible for the speaker, I think there are only 8 speakers worldwide. He need to apply, because the application required, filled in the form, and everything was in electronics, video, all this. So he couldn't do the electronics part. He asked my help for it. So I helped him did that. And after some weeks, he didn't get any news from TI. So it was quite a disappointment for him. So he told me that, how could Toastmasters didn't give me the chance, right? It's the first time in Malaysia. So he was so hopeful that they will give him a slot. And after 2 more weeks, he called me excitedly. He said, you know what? I got better thing than the speaker. Because as a speaker, in a TI convention, you cannot speak to all the delegates. They have a concurrent sessions. Whatever a speaker is speaking, you only have a portion of the audience. But in the opening inspiration speech, with all the 2,700 plus delegates listening to him, and that was what he loved most, because he said it's better than the guest speaker. And he said, only 3 minutes. I said, wow, 3 minutes. And he told me, I remember very well, the shorter the speech is, the more time you need to prepare for it. Because in 3 minutes, you cannot afford to make a single mistake. If it's a 30-minute speech, 40-minute speech, you can make some mistakes and you can still have time to cover up or do some patching. And because of that, he really walked the talk. Spent a lot of time preparing for that 3-minute speech. And he told me, he called Francis Wing to evaluate his speech. You know Francis Wing if you're a member? And Francis Wing really had thumb. And he told me, oh, he said this to me. But he accepted his feedback. And he changed the whole speech. And I think he's the man who really takes feedback as what the Toastmasters is all about. He felt that the feedback was really good for him. And he modified the whole speech. And he told me he changed everything. So I think, as a Toastmasters, we should not be afraid of feedback. We should learn from him. Even as his caliber, he is still willing and humble enough to take.